So what is biodiversity hotspots and why does that matter? I'm Christine Cooper from the School of Molecular and Life Sciences, and I'm a vertebrate ecophysiologist who studies how animals interact with their environment. Biodiversity hotspots were first used in about the mid-1980s to describe areas that have high endemism, so high areas of species that are found nowhere else and that are under threat from the environment. Biodiversity hotspots have been broadened to include any areas that have lots and lots of different species, so mega diverse areas such as Brazil or Colombia or Indonesia. But they've also been used to describe areas that have lots of endemic species, species that are found nowhere else in the world that can also be under threat. And these include areas like Australia and Madagascar. Western Australia is considered to be a biodiversity hotspot because of our high number of endemic species. So we have over 800 plant species that are found nowhere else in the world, and we have some unique fauna that's associated with those plant species. For example, the honey possum is a mammal that feeds only on nectar, which is really unusual amongst mammals. And it can do that because of the wide diversity of flowering plants, which means there's always something in flower for it to feed on. Biodiversity hotspots can be really important because they can help us to focus our conservation efforts. So if we can put effort into conserving areas that have lots of species, we can conserve more species and areas if we focus on areas that have fewer species. About 17 different countries have about two-thirds of the world's species in them, and that includes Australia. And here in the southwest of Australia, we're really fortunate to live and work in an area of world biodiversity. And therefore, we have a great opportunity to work on a whole lot of different species and also those species interactions. It also comes with great responsibility for contributing to the conservation and management of these species.